Hi everyone, I'm Yang Zhuji, a senior product manager from Amazon Redshift. Today, I want to introduce a new capability of single sign-on with AWS IAM Identity Center using Amazon Redshift drivers. My colleague Manish is our senior database engineer. He will show you the demo, how does the feature work. Amazon Redshift was integrated with AWS IAM Identity Center to enable organizations to support trusted identity propagation between Amazon Redshift, Amazon QuickSight, and AWS LakeFormation. Redshift customers can use their organization identities to access Amazon Redshift in a single sign-on experience using third-party identity providers, such as Microsoft Entra ID, Okta, Ping, OneLogin, and so on. Administrators can use third-party identity provider users and groups to manage fine-grained access to data across services and audit user-level access in AWS CloudTrail. Redshift already supported IAM Identity Center authentication from Amazon QuickSight and Query Editor V2. With trusted identity propagation, a user's identity is passed to Amazon Redshift with single sign-on that is managed by IAM Identity Center. Earlier of 2024, Tableau also announced the integration with IAM Identity Center allows you to use OAuth 2.0 OIDC to federate identity from an external identity provider to Amazon Redshift. Now we add this new capability that you can now connect to your data warehouses via GDBC, ODBC, Python drivers from your SQL clients, for example, SQL Workbench J, DBEver, with corporate identity and have a similar single sign-on experience with other AWS services or Redshift tools that already support trusted identity propagation. To use this, you can configure your SQL clients to use IAM Identity Center's authorization by configuring issuer URL, plugin name, and IDC region fields. When your user initiates a query in the SQL client, the driver will initiate OAuth 2.0 based authorization grant with PKCE to IAM Identity Center. There will be a browser pop up. The user enters the credentials in the IDP login page if they haven't already signed into their IDP yet. The driver will call IAM Identity Center with authorization code and finish the REST authorization process. Now Redshift uses the user ID to obtain group membership information from IAM Identity Center and uses group information to authorize access to requested data. Then Redshift can return the result to the query to the users. To learn more about these IAM Identity Center integration, you can explore our blogs. Now I'm transitioning to Manish to walk you through the demos.
Hi everyone, I'm Manish Sharma from AWS Redshift. Today I will be giving demo using SQL Workbench J to connect with Amazon Redshift using IAM Identity Center authentication. In this demo, I will be using Okta as the identity provider. Prerequisites for this demo is to complete Redshift integration with IAM Identity Center. You can follow this blog for the setup. So here is our connection. First thing, you must use the latest Redshift JDBC driver version ending with 30 and above. JDBC URL will be standard JDBC string. In the extended properties, you must specify the following parameters. First one is the issuer URL. For this, you can either use the issuer URL or the AWS Access Portal URL from your IAM Identity Center dashboard. For the plugin name, you have to choose this this new browser IDC auth plugin. For the IDC region, you have to enter the region of your IAM identity center. Choose OK. It will pop up a browser where you will enter your Okta credentials. After entering the credential, it will prompt you with the following notification. Choose Allow Access. Once authentication is successful, you will be redirected to this page. Now we will be running this query. So here we can see we are logged in as Ethan user, and Ethan is part of sales role. Now let's browse the data in sales schema. So you can see Ethan belongs to sales role and he is able to view sales data. This completes our demo on integration of Amazon Redshift with IAM Identity Center using SQL Client. Thanks for watching.